So first, to tell you something about Plastics Europe. We are an European trade association with representatives all across Europe in these 28 member countries. And Plastics Europe has more than 100 member companies producing 90% of all polymers, including EU, including Norway, Switzerland, and Turkey. And what you can see here, this green bubble in the middle is Central Europe. And this is of the biggest region of Plastics Europe, as you can see. It consists of Germany, Switzerland, Austria, Czechia, Hungary, Slovenia, Slovakia, Poland, and the Baltic countries. So all in all, if you not only deal with plastics producers, as we do, the whole plastics industry contributes to 300 billion euros turnover with 1.6 million employees in Europe. This is also the plastics converters and producers to put together. I will come today and give you an overview on the driving forces, some definitions, market frameworks first, then I will come to the bio-based polymers, afterwards the biodegradable ones, have some end-of-life options showing to you and challenges and opportunities of this new family. So the driving forces, there are different driving forces for the bio-based plastic market. One, of course, is cost competitiveness and feedstock flexibility. So companies want to decrease their dependence on fossil fuels and they are looking for alternatives. So this is why also bio-based materials are taken into account. But what you also have on the market is the customer's demand. A lot of brand owners and retailers want to produce different premium products and use bioplastics for this. There are some big companies behind this. This is e.g. Coca-Cola, Danone, Procter & Gamble, or Tetra Pak. And of course, another driving force is the innovation. You have new technologies, feedstocks, and another thing is regulation. You have pressure from regulators, as you heard yesterday also, to mandate the use of more bio-based products. So first of all, I think we heard this already yesterday, but you always have to begin with definitions. What are bioplastics? Bioplastics are bio-based and biodegradable plastics, and also this term is ambivalent. Bio-based plastics are manufactured from renewable resources, but biodegradable plastics, this describes only a functionality. They can be made out of fossil or renewable raw materials. Most times they are blends and mixtures. So here, this one I saw already in your brochure, I will skip this. If you look at this, bio-based plastics today, hype or reality? If you look at this, so you can see this little red part of this graph. Today, plastics produced from renewable materials are still a niche, with possibly 0.4% of the global plastics market today, but with a big growing opportunity for the future. Oh, this one is, I don't know, huh? Does not work. You cannot see the slides here. What you cannot see but should have seen here is the global biopolymers production per region today and in a forecast. It is just shown that the market will be shifted away from Europe to Asia and South America in 2060, a lot. Here you can see what you can also not see because the graphs did not show up, I don't know why. But if you look at the polymer types today, you have a 50-50 ratio when you look at bio-based and biodegradable plastics, but this will shift in the forecast for 2016 enormously. So in the future, it is expected that bio-based will gain most of the market and that biodegradable plastics will be a niche. And looking into details from those polymer types, it's bio-PET which will gain the most market. I think you will have all the things then on your sticks and the presentation, which I sent in before as a PDF. PowerPoint does not work, I think. Okay. So, having highlighted some market framework definitions and driving forces, I will come now to the bio-based polymers. When you have bio-based plastics, you always are asked for the land use they need. Showing this in this graph, you see that nearly everything is used for food and feed, and this is, of course, what is good. And you have only 4% of the harvested agricultural biomass worldwide, which is used for biomass for industrial material. But biomass for industrial material, it's not only bioplastics. So chemical industry today uses about 7% bio-based renewable materials. But most of those are plant extracts, as natural rubber, oleochemicals, and bioplastics is only 2% of this. But when you use more feedstocks, you have to be sure that the raw material you use for chemical industry is available in good and constant quality. So you have to secure supply. Of course, you have to look after the world market prices, which are also going higher and higher, not only the oil prices. And another big thing which we heard about already yesterday is that raw materials should also be sourced sustainable. Especially in Germany, we started with an initiative called INRO, which looks at criteria and that are developed for sustainable use of resources for material use. This is an initiative where industry, associations, NGOs, and the Ministry for Agriculture and Consumer Protection is involved. And there are similar activities in the Netherlands, I think. Looking at bio-based polymers, you have two options. You can either produce new ones, like cellulose derivatives, PRs, or you can make monomers out of that and use that as drop-in monomers to produce polyester amides and everything. So some examples for bio-based plastics, you have the short-life applications, e.g. packaging, of course, but also mulching films. And you have also durable applications, consumer goods, consumer electronics, or automotive. But the packaging is the most dominant application with about 70% of the bioplastics market. And here you can see it's bio-PET is growing, but also the other bio-based materials. Some more examples you can here see from PLR, of course, packaging. You can also use it for fibers and for other consumer goods. You have the specialty polyamides, which are used in a lot of applications in automotive, sport, and leisure. And I saw these kind of examples already also in the brochure of this event. So after having given you an insight in the bio-based polymers, I will come to the biodegradable ones. So examples for biodegradable solutions I can find in shopping bags, in organic waste bags, in agriculture films, but also in packaging, shrink films, and other things. And here, compostable bags can help to divert organic waste into valuable compost. So if you use these biodegradable bags, you can hygienically collect all the organic waste so that it has not been to throw away on a landfill, but in an industrial composter. Another application where it makes sense to use biodegradable plastics are the mulching films. Here you have benefits not to collect the mulching film after harvesting, and no plastic residues will stay in the soil after the harvest. So some considerations now for the end of life of bioplastics. In principle, what you can see from here, every route is possible because you have a big family of different, very different polymers within. You have the PET, you have the PVC, the PP, which is the same whether it is bio-based or not. So only you can have here an additional route for compostable plastics, and this is the industrial compost, where you can see this little seedling, which I will explain now a little bit more on it. So you have compostability as one pillar of those bioplastics. You have norms and standards on this in Europe, worldwide, and in America. And you can have also some certification schemes. I think we will hear on this later in a lecture. So as bioplastics are not one type of materials, but a whole family of different kinds, they can be treated in various recycling and recovery streams, as you can see from here. So the normal waste collection in Germany, you have this yellow bin for plastics packaging and metal packaging, where it is sorted and then comes to energy recovery or to processing and recycling of plastics. Or if you have compostable plastics, you can give this to organic waste collection, and that can be treated then in industrial composting facilities to produce compost. And you have an additional route possible for polylactic acid, which is the feedstock recycling. Here, PLR can be hydrolyzed back to its monomer, lactic acid, and keeps that in a loop. So the considerations, I can put that together again. Products made with bio-based equivalents of those conventional polymers, as I mentioned before, do not differ from the fossil-based products. PLR can also be recovered with mechanical recycling, but then sufficient volumes of this have to be on the market. And what I show you before is that the feedstock recovery can be used for PLR as well. And certified compostable plastics are designed to recover organic recycling and should be given to composting plants. So we had this already, biodegradable plastics. Is this a solution of the litter problem? So it is not, as everyone should know, because no biodegradable plastic is designed to be thrown away into the landscape. Biodegradable plastics biodegrade under controlled conditions and defined conditions. And what is there highlighted in the last point? Only an establishment of a sound waste management system together with education of the consumer, rising awareness, is a sustainable solution. So environmental pollution and its reason, its improper use of landfills, which you can see in some parts, the waste collection systems, which are sometimes broken down or never have been installed. And sometimes it's also the behavior of some consumers, throwaway mentality. So let's focus on the challenges and opportunities with this new family of plastics. Coming to the raw materials, I have shown that availability and logistics of renewable feedstocks in Europe is, of course, a challenge. And you always have to be aware of the discussion which will come to you, food and biopolymers discussion. What is and the raw material prices, food and feed discussion. The technology is also a challenge because you have to combine chemistry and biotechnology, and these are sometimes is not easy to manage. A real opportunity is the use of new feedstocks. So we heard about algaes or lignocellulose biorefineries, and in the nearest future, perhaps also organic waste can be used as a resource. Very important, I think, is the selection of target applications where biopolymers add value, like for the collection of compost and organic waste, mulching films or something. You have the frameworks, you have labels and certification standards, which are on the market, but which are still under development, e.g. for these bio-based definitions and everything, and bio-based measurements. You have also, keep in mind, to support the municipal authorities and clear communicate of what you have, whether you have bio-based, biodegradable, or compostable plastics. So I would like to come to the conclusions. The bio-based and biodegradable plastics are part of the broader family of all plastics. Environmental benefits of bioplastics should be measured via life cycle analysis. I think we will have a lecture on this later on. The current global production capacity is met by using only 0.01% of available arable land. Sustainable sourcing of feedstocks need to be addressed and is addressed at the moment. And as bioplastics are not one type of material but different kinds, they can be treated in the various recycling streams. You have to look, have to take a look at that. And the compostable plastics I already have mentioned. But last but not least, landfill is not an acceptable disposal option, be it for bio-based or biodegradable plastics. So just a few words, what is Plastics Europe's activities on that? We are monitoring the different ongoing activities, cooperate with potential allies and the relevant stakeholders, and especially are active in standardization, e.g. in the German DIN on biodegradable plastics, but also in this bioplastics or bio-based products, standardization organizations, standardization in Europe. And we set up 3 years ago our own bio-based and biodegradable plastics group, which represent companies with commercial production or firm commitment to production of bio-based and or biodegradable plastics. You can see the 8 member companies here. And if you are interested in further details, I recommend to have a look at our homepage. It's plasticseurope.org. And there you can find a section, what is plastics? And we have 2 little bullet points, one on bio-based, one on biodegradable plastics there as well. And you can find there question and answers and some slides like those I showed you today. So let's see it. Plastics are the material of the century. Thank you.